Find all fourth roots of minus 8 minus 8i square root of 3. The first thing that we need to find is r. So how do we find r? Well, we recall that r equals the square root of a squared plus b squared. And we know from our given that a is minus 8 and b is minus 8 square root of 3. So when I plug this in here, I'm going to get the square root of minus 8 squared plus minus 8 square root of 3 squared. And as I simplify this, I'm going to get the square root of 64 plus 192, which is simply the square root of 256, which is what? That's right, it's 16. So I've got my r value. Now I need to find out what is theta, and in order to do that I need to know something about the terminal side. And remember, if we have a graph, I have a negative and a negative, so that puts it down in this quadrant. If it's in that quadrant, I need to figure out what is theta. Well, I know that I have a now, and I also have r, so I can find the cosine of theta, which is going to be a over r. And what is a? Well, we just said that a is minus 8. We just found r, which is 16. So for what angle is the cosine equal to negative 1/2? Well, I know that that makes theta 240 degrees, because remember, it has to be in quadrant 3. And how would I write that in trigonometric form? Well, if I've got r and I've got theta, then I know I can write this in trigonometric form as, and I'm going to come up to the next column, and that would be 16 times the cosine of 240 plus I sine of 240. So far, so good. But now, what did it originally ask me for? It wants the fourth, all the fourth roots. Well, if I'm going to do the fourth roots, then I need to do 16 to the 1/4, right? That would be taking the fourth root of 16. And now this becomes the cosine of what? Well, it becomes the cosine of 240 plus, now what's the period? Remember, we got to do all that period stuff again. And that would be k times 360 divided by 4. Plus, and you knew I'd run out of room, so that's going to be I sine of the same thing. I'm going to have 240 plus k times 360 divided by 4. Well, now once I've done that, it simplifies to something really pretty. It becomes 2 times the cosine of 60 plus k times 90 plus I sine of the same thing, 60 plus k times 90. So far, so good. So now this is written in terms of k, I'm going to actually have to use k values to solve it. This is the final formula that we came up with that we need to use to find all of our fourth roots. So when we do this, we need four roots. So remember, we're going to do 4 minus 1, which is 3. So I'm going to do from 0 to 3, and I'm going to plug those values in for k. So I'm going to have k0, k1, when k is 2, and when k is 3. So what I want you to do is I want you to actually plug those in, come back, and check your answers, and see what you get. Welcome back. So when you've plugged in your values for k, hopefully you've obtained what's over on the right-hand side of the equals. And so the answers are these four right over here on the right.